Hello students, the question is, a particle of mass m is dropped from a height h above the ground. At the same instant, another particle of the same mass is thrown vertically upwards from the ground with a speed of root over 2gh. If they collide head on completely inelastically, the time taken for the combined mass to reach the ground in units of root over h by g is, the options are given. This question is taken from JEE Main 2020 online paper, 8 January, second half. Let's read the question again. A particle of mass m is dropped from a height h above the ground. First, I will draw the situation. See, this is the ground. A particle of mass m is released from rest at a height h from the surface. Now coming to the second line, at the same time another particle of the same mass, that is m, is thrown vertically upwards from the ground with a speed of root over 2gh. Therefore, there is another mass m, it is thrown from ground with an initial velocity of root over 2gh. Coming to the question again, if they collide head on completely inelastically in between this point and this point, first we have to find the exact position where the two particles will collide. For that we have to consider, let after time t the two particles will collide in midair. Okay, therefore in this time t this particle will cover a distance, this, let us find that. Suppose this is h1 is nothing but ut plus half t square. U is 0 because the particle is released from rest, so 0 into t plus the acceleration is obviously acceleration due to gravity, half g t square. So h1 is half g t square, right? Now let us calculate the distance covered by the second particle in upward direction. Let's name it h2. So h2 is, now u is not 0, u is root over 2gh, and I consider upward direction as positive. So u is positive, root over 2gh, time is same t. Now in this case it is deceleration of same value g. Now this is the value of h2. Since the two particles collide here, I can say h1 plus h2 is nothing but h, right? Putting the values h1 and h2, this half gt square and minus half gt square will go. Therefore, root over 2gh into t equals to h. Hence, the time of collision is nothing but h by root over 2gh, that is root over h by 2g. Okay. Therefore, after this time, root over h by 2g, the two particles will collide. Now we have to find the velocities of each particle at the just before the collision at this point, right? Okay. Now, for the first one, for the first particle, velocity at this point will be v equals to 0 plus g into t. And what is the value of t? We get root over h by 2g. Putting this, h by 2g, and it is nothing but root over gh by 2, right? This is the velocity of the first particle and it is in downward direction, v1. For the second particle, let's find the velocity v2 just before the collision. V2 is u root over 2gh minus gt, right? Putting the value of t again, we will get root over 2gh minus root over gh by root 2, that is root 2 minus 1 by root 2 root over gh, which is nothing but, see, the value of v2 is same as v1. So value of v2 is same as v1. Interesting point to note. Another thing that we have to find is this height. And in the last slide, you see this height is nothing but h2, and the value of h2 is this thing, right? I have to find the value of h2. H2 is root over 2gh into t minus half gt square. Putting the value of t again, I will get 2gh h by 2g minus half g h by 2g, and it is h minus h by 4, that is 3h by 4. Therefore, I can say the two particles, the position of collision of the two particles is situated at a height 3h by 4 above the ground. So h2 is 3h by 4. Okay. Now, coming to the question again. See, according to the question, the two particles collide inelastically. Okay. Therefore, by using principle of conservation of linear momentum, and it's an instantaneous use of principle of conservation of linear momentum, we can use this principle in this case just before and just after the collision happens. So just before the collision, okay, the first particle is moving downward with velocity, you can see, root over gh by 2, and the other particle is moving upward with same velocity, root over gh by 2. So just before the collision, the total linear momentum of the system is nothing but m root over gh by 2 minus m root over gh by 2, which is 0. Now, just after the collision, since the collision is inelastic collision, we know in case of inelastic collision, the two bodies move together, right? The total mass of the system is 2m, and let the velocity is v. Now, using the principle of COLM, initial total linear momentum is equal to final total linear momentum. So, of course, v is 0. Therefore, just after the collision, on inelastic collision, the two bodies will come to rest. Okay, student? The two bodies will come to rest. And the two bodies, which has a total mass of 2m, is situated at a height of 3h by 4, right? And their initial velocity is 0. Therefore, coming to the question again, the time taken for the combined mass to reach the ground, which is very simple. We will use the formula s equal to ut plus half a t square. S equals to ut plus half a t square. S is 3h by 4, u 0 plus half acceleration g into t square. Therefore, t will come as root over 3 by 2 into root over h by g. And in the question you can see the time in units of root over h by g, that means what factor of root over h by g is required. And you can see root over 3 by 2 times of root over h by g. So the answer is root over 3 by 2. Option C is correct. I hope you understand this question. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel PhiSolver.